the road to WrestleMania continues here, ladies and gentlemen, for Whassup Wrestling. Monday night we have here for Salt Lake. Are you ready? As well as this crowd. We are starting off this night, ladies and gentlemen, with a tag team match featuring the 2024 Royal Rumble winner on the Vixen side, Kaio, with best friend Jessica Jenkins. They are coming down outside the lane. Tremendous matchup here, as on WhassupWrestling.com, Kaio made it clear her intentions of challenging Lady Chaos in order to retake the Vixen's championship. Stating in that interview that she felt that she did not do the title justice. Feeling like she was more of a transitional champion. Exactly a huge claim to fame on her career, and so she is hoping to do things right. Along with her best friend and mentor on her side. She will do well at WrestleMania when she takes on Lady Chaos. Now, though, a bit of a preview as the team of Jessica Jenkins and Kaio take on the Broken Toys, Lady Chaos, and Samantha Darkstar. As we knew that this would happen, I mean, both individuals represent tag teams. So the lights go out. It's been now over a year since Cyclones transitioned into becoming Samantha Darkstar. Since then, has stood at Lady Chaos' side as her lackey. Lady Chaos becoming the Vixen's champion back in SummerSlam, defeating Emily Stratfield. Went out against Roxy Stevenson at Royal Rumble. She was able to bypass Elimination Chamber, now going straight to WrestleMania, where her opponent has been named. The opponent stands inside the ring at this very moment. Interestingly, that Lady Chaos transitioning Samantha Darkstar into her line of thinking. I don't really see these two tag team together too often. More so they stand in one another's corner. I'm sure that Samantha will be in Lady Chaos's corner in just a few weeks' time. Here. Samantha just stands in the background. No challenge on her position, I suppose. You know, looks like it'll be starting off with Samantha and Kaio. And here we go. Bell is rung. No one in the corner of the Broken Toys, but Alleyne, the mentor, who just a couple weeks ago defeated Kaio in a one-on-one contest, ended up shaking her hand despite defeating her, feeling that she was worthy enough of going ahead on her challenge. A pair of forearms to the back of Samantha and a double axe handle onto the thigh. Kaio now up onto the middle rope. Lady Chaos, unfortunately unable to get Kaio off. Kaio's leg strength and balance, her determination to keep up on that top, on that middle turnbuckle. Little Samantha able now to turn things around. across the chest and DDT onto Kaio. Huge victory it would be for Samantha to pick up a win over Kaio. And top rope, Hurricane Rana. This does not bode well for the Royal Rumble winner. But countering out of that powerbomb situation with a DDT. Kind of bringing Samantha up. Trying for a scoop slam, could not get it in, shoved ahead, and tilt-a-whirl head scissors, double tilt-a-whirl. Kaio managed to turn things around, tag out to Jessica. And Jessica attempting a knee, but Samantha grabs hold, brings her towards the ropes, and Jessica fighting back. Pair of elbows. Now meets, taking her down. Lady Chaos attempting for a tag, but Samantha really realized what was going on. Chaos just misses out on that attempt right there. I don't think that's something that Alleyne taught her. On the shoulders. Absolute strength there by Jessica Jenkins. And Samantha countering. And a shooting star press. Front headlock, and now making the next attempt, bringing her into the Broken Toys corner. Tag out to Lady Chaos. Pulling her head steady, and Chaos comes in with the boot. Disrespectful slap from Lady Chaos, and Jessica Jenkins not going to take that one lying down. Gets in a hefty kick to beneath the jaw, and a standing Hurricane Rana. Pulling her away from the Broken Toys corner. And tag out to Kaio. And here we go, the preview of the WrestleMania matchup for the Vixens Championship. Shot straight to the face, turning Chaos around, and up and over. And Kaio going to work between the shoulder blades, now up onto the middle rope, and barely gives Chaos enough time to react. Top rope, or middle rope splash, sorry. Chaos fighting back. And attempts a neck breaker, but Kaio shoving her away, kick to the gut, and sling blade. Into the corner, in comes Kaio. Tag out to Jessica. Oh, nice double kick there. And Jessica with the cover. Got only Samantha able to come in. And, oh, down against the top rope. Where's Jessica going? Up onto the top. Top rope frog splash. And Jessica's not finished. Going up onto the top of another corner. This time, senton. Once again into the Kaio Jessica Jenkins corner. Lady Chaos is just on absolute dream speed, and again, that sweeping kick, that double kick. Here's the cover again. And this time, and of course, Chaos would not be able to get up from that. Just an absolute destruction at the end there. Kaio and Jessica Jenkins victorious here tonight. But you know what the question is I'm going to ask, ladies and gentlemen? Do you take two creams with your coffee? And will this be the same effect on WrestleMania? Lady Cash defends the Vixens Championship against Kaio. See it again, Kaio and Jessica Jenkins victorious here. Alleyne celebrating on the outside. Tremendous victory for this team. Jessica telling Kaio to help celebrate this one. WrestleMania has just gotten bigger, has just gotten healthier. Well, as Kaio and Jessica Jenkins continue on their celebration, now time for Wild Child to take on Stan Stevens. Last week, Stan Stevens was supposed to face off against Bobo, but Stan, for whatever reason, attacked Bobo on his way to the ring. A steel chair, and things ultimately did not work out for him, but the match did not happen. What is Stan Stevens now with a sledgehammer? This time connects, sledgehammer right to the back. What the hell has gotten into Stan Stevens? Now just a elbow to the knee, just a leg breaker onto the handle of the sledgehammer, and again Stan Stevens is just trying to put Wild Child away here. What exactly is going on in Stan Stevens' head here? Does he not want to compete? He spent all his time trying to prove himself a proper contender for the $1 million championship. Well, these are your opportunities, Stan. Wild Child able to fight back. That pain's got to be... I mean, there's got to be adrenaline at this point. Running elbow straight down to the back. Again, I don't know what is going on. Referee calling on this one. Wild Child victorious, but what is going on? Joined by Honey Rydell, making her way to the ring, mic in hand. I wonder if she's here to speak on behalf of Anya in regards to the future of the Women's Championship. Well, Emily did win it, and I'm certain that right after it was presented to the Goddess of the Harem. So let's hear what the Harem has to say. tremendous news here for the Women's Championship. I mean, if you're a fan of the harem, Honey Rydell and Emily Stratfield fighting for that belt and for their goddess's love at WrestleMania. What a matchup that will be. What does that mean for Kaio? And we are back, ladies and gentlemen. Wild Child getting some medical attention in the back following that sledgehammer shot and those repeated drops onto that sledgehammer. As Claude Daniels of the PTC takes on AJ Smyth in an Extreme Rules contest for that third of the fourth spot in the Fatal 4-Way Hardcore Iron Woman matchup at WrestleMania. This one will join the likes of... apologies there. Kimberly, Cindy Sullivan, and Catalina Starr. Sure that Cindy Sullivan would love for the opportunity to have AJ represent. Though Claude Daniels, who recent employee into the Page Turning Centerfold, crawling her way over AJ, and just headbutts. Not how I thought that would end, but AJ now rolling over, rises up to her feet. Mid-rope Hurricane Rana, AJ rolls to the outside for some chance of reprieve here. Tremendous opportunity for Claude Daniels, not only for a potential shot at her first championship, but a victory over AJ Smyth would certainly set her up high in the rankings of any other championship. AJ now heading for a weapon, pulls out a baseball bat and clocks Claude right between the eyes. Picks the bat back up and down. Ooh, almost trying for the thighs there, but Claude wrestles it away. Now catches AJ between the eyes. So they've both felt it. I know it's not something they want to feel again, but Claude Daniels ramming her into the steel steps. Honestly, Claude Daniels has been on a roll here in this matchup, surprisingly. And, ooh, suplex down onto those mats. Baseball bat down to the lower back. And now the steel steps. This one continuing up. This is not a falls count anywhere matchup, but they certainly seem to be acting like it. With another headbutt. AJ back into the ring, and Chloe, that's the thing, that she was going to go for that baseball bat once more, but ultimately joins her in there. Slams into the corner, and Chloe coming up. And tornado DDT. I don't see either of the PTC or Paige out here. Though I'm certain that they are supporting her in the back. And AJ once again onto the outside. Claude Daniels with something in her mind. What has she got here? Gonna take the high risk of fence here. And through the ropes! Shoulder block sending AJ hard against the barricade. Absolutely sprawled out. AJ kicking away, managing to counter up with another kick. And down onto the arm. And back into the ring, AJ joining up rather quickly. Into the ropes, and running elbow straight into the back. This is a stomp on the butt for good measure. Ropes and a low drop kick taking her down. AJ can certainly feel it here. Stomp on the back, just hitting Klo right back down, who tries to get away. AJ not going to let her, and there's that inside elbow. And the cover, first cover of this matchup, surprisingly. And that is it. AJ Smyth victorious here. So AJ Smyth will be joining up alongside Catalina Starr, Cindy Sullivan, and Kimberly for that Hellcat Championship matchup. I'm sure that Cindy is more than pleased about that, as AJ now going for a handshake. And Klo Daniels, not a good sport on this one. Well, congratulations indeed to AJ, but again, another sign of disrespect. Ranger making his way backstage. We heard that he was coming back. Hung on Moose, and what is this? Trying to hype each other up or something. Dork Killer making his way to the ring. I don't know what was going on in the backstage area between Moose and Ranger, but well, since we've seen Ranger following, I don't know if it was a banning or a charge or what have you, but he did get in that strike against Alexis King some weeks ago. But Ranger is back and Dork Killer has the mic. Killer bit issuing the challenge at WrestleMania. He's already defeated Hype. Now he's going after his oldest brother, Violence John, and what a contest that stems to be, ladies and gentlemen. WrestleMania getting bigger and bigger as we approach. As I said, WrestleMania just getting bigger and bigger. On top of that, we have to remember that Craig Stevens will be taking on Ric Flair. Ric Flair's last ever Whassup Wrestling matchup. See how he does here. Craig Stevens has not had the best record going against the Four Horsemen. Ric Flair has yet to say anything about stopping the match between himself and Craig Stevens. So hopefully this is where Craig turns things around. Finally maintains a victory. Or all three members will have defeated a former Universal Champion. So the Mike Stevens being accompanied by Maple. At one point did get physical in a few matches, especially that moment where Alexis King did get struck by a Ranger. The powerhouse of the Four Horsemen making his way to the ring. The last surviving member of the Four Horsemen when it came to their Survivor Series matchup against the Fortunate Sons and Tony J. Smyth. Let's see how this one plays out. Powerhouse, the Horseman. Both men are ready for this one, and there is the bell. Craig Stevens stepping up first, and right into a back elbow from Greg Faith. Stevens able to catch hold, and spinning heel kick. People celebrating on the outside. And DDT down onto Craig Faith. Referee racing around. And it's just a single headbutt, and Craig Stevens hop around DDT. Snapmare. And a running snapmare to top it off. And people clapping their paws together. And leg drop. Drake fighting here with a purpose tonight. Looking to go 3-for-0. Or 0-for-3, there we go. It's a more applicable way of putting it. Taking Greg down with a neck breaker. Middle rope and diving the elbow. Once more going for the cover and just a one count. Elbow strikes. And the crowd counts. And for good measure. And Craig Stevens now ready to put this one away. Greg Faith getting to his feet. From behind, Craig Stevens special. Nothing he could do there. And here's the cover. Very quickly down in position. And almost in quick order. A bit frustrated there, but nothing he can do. Greg did kick out. Greg fighting back, elbow to the face, but Craig Stevens whipping across the ring. A slow walk, doesn't seem to matter. Kick to the gut and attempting to keep up some stomps. Alex swept out from under him as Greg brings him back up. Sends him into the ropes. Craig just colliding with Faith there. Shot to the side of the head. And Samoan drop. They're being sent right out of Craig's lungs there. Set up and a knee to the back. Bring up onto the middle rope. They have planned here. Middle rope neck breaker. Just flipping around, taking Craig down. Bringing him up and trying for a pop-up powerbomb. But Craig Stevens counters with a Hurricane Rana. And down goes Greg. don't think Greg Faith thought that was going to be possible at any point. Still heavily stunned. Can't get in anything at all. Neckbreaker now. Craig Stevens up onto the middle rope. Feeling out this capacity crowd. Now ready to put this one away. Catching Greg again. Craig Stevens special. Straight right into the cover. Here's the count. And this one should be over. Craig Stevens countering out the pop-up powerbomb, which could have been the end. That's the Craig Stevens that we all know and all love. Craig Stevens victorious here. Finally getting that victory. Finally showing what he is capable of. Just an immediate assault from start to finish. I don't think Greg even knew what hit him. See that first Craig Stevens special. It's not enough to put him away. That Famouser up into days of down. Long enough to deliver the second Craig Stevens special as Craig victorious here celebrating his victory. This next stop, WrestleMania, where he will take on Ric Flair. Fuck with the juggalo. Who out there said tag team action player? Then we do it again, bitch. You the first Kaio and Jesse Jenkins versus Broken Toys wasn't enough. Now we have Bonk and Doink set to take on Area 51 in a Tornado Extreme Rules matchup. Been a lot of speculation on who will face off against the Heroes for Hire for the tag team championships. Just a few weeks' time at WrestleMania. A lot of hope that it is going to be Bonk and Doink. Well, they were the ones to defeat a team of Buddy and Blithe Omega. Not an easy feat. They're managing to do so on their own merit. High up in the rankings. And a victory here against Area 51 would definitely solidify that. Again, that is if they are victorious here tonight. If not, well, the question will remain unanswered. Area 51 making their way to the ring. No Alexa Bliss. This is an Extreme Rules contest. Roswell not wanting to see his girlfriend getting inadvertently hit by anything during this one. Not that he doesn't think that she could take it, but he just doesn't want her to get caught up in the crossfire here. Let's go. After all, she's taking part in her own set of Extreme Rules matchups, but she's playing support. There we go, one fall to a finish. There's the bell. Both men are all four coming in. Be Roswell and Bonk, Doink, and 51. Bonk with a standing drop kick. Bonk and Doink right on top of Area 51 here. Already a submission maneuver, but Bonk cutting it off early. And 51 with a headbutt as Roswell launches in a few shots. Doink grabbing hold of something. Sledgehammer, is that the same sledgehammer that Stan Stevens was using earlier? Hit down by the tables, and there's DDT onto that unprotected area. It's Roswell now. Hurricane run on Bonk. Just like the AJ Smyth and Claude Daniels matchup earlier, this is not a false count anywhere matchup. Mile 51 and Doink are damaging each other. Roswell and Bonk are what you could call the legal competitors, even though all four of them are legal. 51 with that sledgehammer again, trying to go for the knee. And powerbomb right to the turnbuckle. goggles from Bonk to Roswell as Bonk and Doink, I was about to say, right back on top of things, but 51 managing to get Doink away, and Roswell eating the top turnbuckle and saying it tasted yummy. Straight out of the corner, and 51 again with that sledgehammer. Doink rolls away, tosses it away, and sends it straight into the gut. And there's that Boston Crab again. Roswell able to utilize his leg strength, and now double cover here. Unfortunately, referee was paying more attention to Doink and 51. Gorilla press, and down goes Roswell. As again, Bonk and Doink now right on top of Area 51. DDT on 51. These four members just switched places, not dance partners. 51 fighting right back, Jawbreaker. And a rock-a-bye baby right from the corner as Roswell managing to fight back, sending Bonk's face a couple of times into the post and now into the barricade and ramming it straight against it as well. That corner part of the barricade as 51 heads out of the ring, perhaps to assist or to find, no, just to find something else. Goes with that baseball bat. Saw that one in play earlier. Finally managed to get into something here. Roswell, Doink sent right into the corner. Roswell joining up. At very least, keeping Bonk busy. Another spinning heel kick. And 51. No, Doink managing to counter out there, getting in behind. And down goes 51. Cover. Roswell raising in. Would he have made it in time? It doesn't seem to matter whether we know or not. Roswell now looking for something. Finds out a kendo stick. Can't decide whether he wants it or not. And drop kick. And Bonk racing right back in here. And power bomb on Roswell. Roswell rolling to the outside. Really shouldn't have hesitated with that kendo stick. 51 alone in the ring with both Bonk and Doink. Not the best position to be in. And Bonk hitting the ropes. And all that weight coming down on the back of 51's head. Both Area 51 taken out at the same time there. Dance partners have finally been switched. Roswell coming in from behind. Here, 51, back body drop. 51's leg swept out from under him. And a headbutt from Roswell. Knee to the face. I think that Bonk thought that Doink had taken care of Roswell, but instead unable to. And rubber chicken. Bonk managing to get in the rubber chicken. And up and over goes 51. Surprisingly, no attempt on a cover on Roswell. Oh! Terrific height from Roswell. He's heading up to the top. And shooting star, but completely misses. Or at least narrowly misses, almost hit the target. Roswell gonna try again. Just take the risk. And reverse DDT. Bonk rolling to the outside. Now Doink alone with Area 51. And ooh! Misplaced shot there from Roswell, catching 51. Hopefully that's not what cost them. And no! Down goes Roswell. Here's the cover. And with a misplaced shot, 51 unable to make this save. Bonk and Doink victorious. Get another shot of that shot. I don't think the replay people will find that to be too interesting, honestly. I mean, if they're seeing just a couple of shots in the face, it's interesting. It's another rubber chicken. But yes, a misplaced shot. Roswell at 51 sending him out of the ring. Immediate control there with the whooping cushion. Coming out of this one victorious. Bonk and Doink perhaps solidifying their eventual challenge for the tag team titles against the Heroes for Hire. Tremendous matchup here. And we only are just continuing on. Just moments ago, Crackerjack and Canuck. It did not take long for them to get into each other's faces. And exciting hatred between these two men. Former tag team partners, former tag team champions, fighting it out in the backstage area, as I call this. As I call this now, calling on the replay. Remember what I said earlier. Security racing in. Eventually did manage to get between these two men, stopping it. Right before they kill each other or destroy this building, whichever indeed happened first. Absolute slugfest, not certain what was going on here. And, well, there's some property damage already. And again, that poor box did nothing. It was just being a box. Ranger, I'm just seeing Maple's name, and Maple out back here with Boops. Now Boops in his following well up that Maple came out to congratulate her former client. Need some over there. Breaker was amicable. No issues caused. Or is she out here? Or Alexis King? Will definitely be in the corner of Blithe Omega. Moose has been on a bit of a losing streak as of late, ever since winning the Royal Rumble. His chances tonight are no better. He takes on Blithe Omega, the living end. And then brought into this company by Alexis King. You see her there. Last time you saw Alexis King was she was struck down by Ranger inside the ring. Just recently seeing Ranger earlier tonight. The fit of get ready for this one, making his way now to the ring. One half of the $1 billion assassins. alongside the Universal Champion and Moose's eventual opponent at WrestleMania, Buddy. It will be a potential ring-destroying matchup. The absolute size of these two men look an absolute powerhouse. Moose perhaps will have the speed advantage. That be enough when he takes on the Living End. And here we go. Maple is certainly no stranger to Blithe Omega. She was there for his first ever matchup against Craig Stevens. The night that Craig Stevens turned things around, going 20 minutes with Blithe Omega. Saw the quickness of Blithe of Moose, and now we see the power of Blithe Omega. Shot to the gut. And up and over. Fall away slam. Moose sent clear across the ring. Now Blithe Omega uncharacteristically on the middle rope and pays for it. Both men lock eye to eye. What Moose was thinking. He pulls Blithe into a shoulder block. Now Moose gonna show his own power, bringing Blithe up and back down again. Blithe sent over the top rope, but manages to stay back in the ring, comes right back in. Everything that Moose may even be taller than Blithe Omega, and I don't mean just by his mohawk. Again, up on the middle rope. Crashes down. Not much distance, but the power behind it has got to be enough. As Moose again, shoulder block, and a stomp down into the arm. Moose is not going down without a fight here. Nice little neck breaker from Moose to Blithe Omega. That's whatever Ranger told him is working here. Ranger, the only man to have defeated Blithe Omega in a one-on-one situation. To turn things around there. Certainly those two will collide at some point in time in the future. And German suplex from Blithe Omega to Moose. Bringing Moose back up, and another German suplex. Third and final one, finally the release. And swept up, taken down. Maybe just taking immediate control of this one. But Moose, again, fighting back. Focusing in on the arm. Counters out. And backbreaker. Breaker connects there. Blithe just on an absolute mean streak here. Keeping up the assault. Now with a camel clutch as Alexis King gets to watch the pained expression of Moose. To come out of there. Bringing in some distance. Shot to the back of the head, and again. To the ropes and flung right back, narrowly taking out the referee. Blithe with a back body drop brings Moose back up to his feet. And Koji clutch on Moose. Is Moose about to tap out? Moose fighting and struggling. Not going to give up. WrestleMania can't hold on to it forever. But he can wait. Poised and ready for the Judgment Day. Moose up on the shoulders, and there it is. Just a brief pause, and now cover, middle of the ring. Maple doing what she can to get Moose up, and it's enough. Moose with a kick out from the Judgment Day. Judgment Day following the Koji clutch, and Moose still fighting. The end may be coming for him soon. Stiff shot again. Kick right to the back. Moose was at least showing himself tough enough to keep up with Blitz Omega, just unfortunately now being torn apart. Blitz Omega forcing the viewers to gaze upon the blood flowing out from Moose's forehead. Moose still fighting back. Back body drop again. A punch in the shoulders. And what is this? No! Down onto the knees. And where's Moose going? Moose with a running knee straight to the side of Blitz's head. But Moose isn't finished yet. It will be, will we be seeing a gas Moose on the loose? Blitz Omega stampeded right down. Here's the cover, middle of the ring. Will this, no. Two count only, but Moose managing to collide straight through Blitz Omega with that Moose on the loose. Blitz Omega still down and out. Don't think he knew exactly what hit him or what crushed him, really. DDT on Moose. Blitz Omega regaining his senses here. Trying in for those Germans. Getting in a second. Can the third one? And third one connects. And again with the Koji clutch. Is Moose gonna tap out here? And Moose does tap out. Blitz Omega victorious here against Moose. Tremendous effort, however, by Moose. The way up the 6 feet necessary to crack a Bliss chest. Blitz Omega managed to counter out, getting in those jerks in clutch of this matchup. Oh, here we go. Ranger now at the end of the entryway, and Maple may want to keep. And Alexis King now. Alexis King. Pandemonium breaking out here, ladies and gentlemen, as Ranger attempting to keep hold of Blitz Omega. Maple even getting himself involved. Moose has already left the ring. Alexis King not backing down. Moose is just trying to get his way to the backstage area, but Buddy, oh, and Moose with a couple of shots, and Buddy. And Buddy sending Moose right into the locker room. That's pretty much where Moose wanted to go. And Buddy just continuing the assault on Moose. Moose, who had just finished off a fight against Blitz Omega. Back outside, ladies and gentlemen, Buddy just lying in wait here